at the park again today. Another nice day. Actually, even better than yesterday. Yesterday was a little cloudy, but today it's like perfectly sunny. Plus, I came out earlier, so I have more sun to deal with. So that's good. Starting off the workout with some pull-ups, but more specifically, one-arm assisted pull-ups. So I'm going to use like a piece of cloth. This was a shirt that I found on the park. So I'm going to use it as an assistant. So I'm going to hold it with one hand, and then the other hand holds the bar and does pull-ups. Going to do 3 each side, then going to superset that with 10 single hand steel mace 360s on either side. Looks like this. Moving into the steel mace 360s, the reason for pairing these two movements is I find that something about pull-ups causes my shoulder to tighten up a little, and by pairing it with steel mace 360s, especially one arm at a time, I'm able to focus on the shoulder rotation aspect that gets a little tight from pull-ups for me, and so it helps keep my shoulder loose and not have to face that problem. But yeah, 10 each side. I'm gonna do this for a couple of sets, then there's probably gonna be a lot of kettlebell juggling in today's video. It might even be a longer one. There's a lot of daylight left and I plan on being out for a while. So yeah, these two for a bit, then on to something else. For the next circuit, doing circuit / superset, whatever, I'm going to do 5 pull-ups. Regular, and then superset that with steel mace 360 to side drop single-handed, and going to go for 6 reps but split them up into 2s, and I'll show you what I mean by that in a second. But let's get the 5 pull-ups in. So for the 360s, I'm going to do a 360, side drop back to center, 360, side drop back to center, and then I'm gonna go 6. Thank you. So yeah, I'm gonna do this for a bit. I've already done like 6 sets of it. Probably gonna get 10 and then on to something else. In a couple of previous videos, I did single hand steel mace 360 while holding a kettlebell. And so I started thinking, what if I threw a lunge in the middle of it? So that led me to this next circuit. So going to hold the kettlebell and do a 360 and then a lunge at the end of each 360 for 6 360s on each side, but with lunges, with one lunge in the middle of it, if that makes sense. It looks like this. So, starting off in the usual hold 360 position. 360, lunge. 360, lunge. Switching sides. And then going to do a single forward flip, then a reverse flip to switch hands for 3 each side. So yeah, gonna do this for another 4 or 5 sets and then on to the next thing. So for the next circuit, it's going to be a little longer than the previous 3. So going to start off with some push-ups, then move into a moving clean and press. And gonna do 5 of those. On each side, looks like this. So going to start off with 3 push-ups. Going to step ahead. Clean. Press. Switch sides. Getting some chest in the beginning. Cleaning and press involves the legs and the shoulders, some back. So yeah, good full body movement here. Oof. How many was that? I'm gonna go for 3 of those. I don't know if what number I said before, but it's 3 of the complex, I guess. So yeah, that's the complex. Then for the next part of things, with the steel mace, I'm going to do a single arm 360 to squat. So the goal here is to be able to maintain that stability of holding the steel mace upright while performing a squat. Going for 5 each side. So yeah, doing 5 each side of that, and then I think it was 3 complexes on each side of the kettlebell. But yeah, gonna do this again for 5-6 sets, I don't know, and then on to something else. Ending off the workout with freestyle kettlebell juggling.
on.
That's all for today's video. See you all tomorrow.